Welcome back, everyone, of the Westlake Hornets Team Builder Dynasty here in NCAA Football 14. As today, we got some Saturday Night Football between the 3-5 Washington State Cougars and the 5-3 Westlake Hornets. These two teams have had polar opposite seasons. I don't know why I put an R at the end. Let me try that again. These two teams have had polar opposite seasons, as Washington is 3-5, 1-4 in conference, while Westlake is 5-3, 4-1 in conference. The Hornets are currently ranked number 21 after one of their biggest wins in program history, demolishing the struggling 2-7 UCLA Bruins 49-6. As Burmester has been buzzing for a couple reasons, with the first one being running back Alex Ellis is now fourth on the Heisman watch. This is the first time in school history that a player has been on the Heisman watch. And then the second thing is, after visiting the campus last week, four-star quarterback Peyton Curtis has committed to the Hornets. So Westlake likely has their Champ Britton replacement. As welcome to the Hornets' Nest here in Burmester, Utah, 3-5 Washington State Cougars take on the 5-3 Westlake Hornets. Let's get right
into it. Here's the Westlake offense, one of the best offensive units in the country, as they have the football after a quick 3-and-out from Washington State.
Champ Britton and Alex Ellis in the backfield, as it's going to be a handoff for Mr. Heisman watch, but Ellis loses 3 yards on the play. Nice play from the Cougar defense.
Both teams started this game off with a 3-and-out. Obviously, don't expect Westlake to get too many more 3-and-outs on offense. And Washington State does have a respectable offense, so I think they'll have this pretty solid day. As on first down, Chip Barron reads the play like a book, and Caleb Perry has nowhere to go. Not his fault, but poor run block.
Third down and two for the Cougars. Let's see if they can convert, as Connor Neville has an open man up the middle. That's the tight end, Thomas. McNamara can't make the tackle, and that'll be 24 yards for Nick Thomas. Washington State is in the red zone for the first time today. Obviously, they are 0-0 so far. Let's see if they can put up some points and take the lead. As on second down and four, it's going to be an option. Toss for Perry, and he fumbles the football. That's a Gobo Anecho with the force. His third straight week with a huge fumble force, and the true freshman linebacker has been really playing some excellent football as he makes another big play there. The ball clearly went out before his knee was down. That'll be Westlake football as they get a stop in the red zone. It is second down and 11 after a 1 yard loss, as Britton scrambling with it. Champ Britton can't find anyone. Now he does. He connects with Everett Lemieux, the speedy freshman, who will gain 28.
12 for 14, 204 yards and a touchdown. That was the stat line for Champ Britton a week ago. He did get injured early in the second half, but before that, he was playing really well as Britton throws a dart for the redshirt sophomore Michael Wilson, who gets the score, and the Hornets are the first ones to get points with just 55 seconds left in the first quarter. Take another look. Excellently ran route from Wilson as Britton. Perfect pass, perfect play, and the Hornets take the lead.
We have a studio update from our good friends over at EA Sports. Arizona State taking on UCLA. Westlake's opponent last week taking on Westlake's opponent next week, and it's a close game, but two touchdowns from John Smith gives the Bruins the lead, as Jack Jackson also has two touchdowns, and he would love to get his Sun Devils a win before bringing them here into Burmester. Westlake's defense forced a turnover, courteous of the true freshman Agobo Anecho Jr., and the Hornets offense capitalized as they lead it 7-0. Connor Neville under pressure, and that's Quinn Campbell, the redshirt junior, with the interception. Campbell runs past a few defenders, and Quinn Campbell, who had an interception last week, gets another one here. And that's the second turnover for this Westlake defense, a unit that has struggled forcing turnovers this season, but the past couple games, it really looks like they're forcing more and more. Not too long ago, it was just nothing-nothing, and now this could be 14-0 with a blink of an eye. As on first down, Ellis, Britton, and Jackson all in the backfield. Britton, no time to throw it. He's going to be sacked by Dominic Civils. Westlake had it 4th-and-2 on the Washington State 15. While a lot of coaches would go for it, the Hornets decided to take the points. And it's now 10-0. It's on third down. Connor Neville up the middle for Ware, as Brock Rivero almost got to the quarterback for a sack, but instead of it, it'll be a 19-yard game for Adam Ware.
It is first down after the conversion for the Cougars. Perry and Neville in the backfield, four wide set. It's going to be an option kept by Connor Neville. Neville is blocked. I don't think anyone's going to catch him. And Connor Neville will take it home for a touchdown. And just like that, it's going to be a three-point game.
This studio update presented by EA Sports as the Sun Devils come from behind and get the win over UCLA 29-26. Arizona State improves to 5-4 as they head to Westlake next week.
Westlake was able to get a field goal in their last drive. Let's see if they can score some more points and extend their lead. Just under 5 minutes to go left in the first half. Handoff for Ellis, who's had a rough day, and his rough day continues. Not that it's his fault, because the run blocking has been far from kind. It's been a rough one for Alex Ellis. He has 6 carries for 7 yards, but it's not his fault, as Westlake's run blocking has been pretty bad so far today. As Champ Britton on first down has an open man deep, that's Michael Wilson, who will bring it down at around the 35 or 36. After a dominant second half a week ago from backup quarterback Benjamin Gold, Champ Britton is proving that he still belongs to be this team's starter. So on third down, Britton looking to throw. He is an open man, that's Everett Lemieux, who will bring it to the one.
Minute 54 left to go until halftime. Hornets still lead it 10-7.
As it's second down and goal, Britton and Ellis in the backfield. Sandu fishing in motion. Handoff for Alex Ellis, who will get the touchdown, his 18th rushing touchdown of the season. And the Hornets extend their lead with a minute 52 left to go until halftime.
Here returns for Washington State offense. They scored a touchdown in their last drive as Connor Neville. He's intercepted. That's Quinton Campbell with his second of the game. As Campbell, who of course got burned at the end of the USC game and is the reason why Westlake lost, he's been playing really well since then, as he has 2 interceptions in the first half today, and Westlake should be able to add some more
Westlake
points.
Was unable to get a touchdown, so here's Matt Fellows for the field goal to end the half. It's a fake! Benjamin Gold finds Jeff Washington, and the fake field goal is successful, and the Hornets get the touchdown. What a play call by head coach Mason Conway as Gold, the senior who had 3 passing touchdowns in relief of Britton a week ago, gets another one there.
Westlake has played another really solid game of football on both sides of the ball, especially defense, as while they have 24 points, their offense hasn't been 24 points good. As Britton, he will find an open Everett Lemieux, who was very good in the first half, as Lemieux gains 23 yards.
3rd down and 9 for Westlake. They're not quite in field goal range. Let's see if they can convert here. As Britton, he will be sacked. No time to throw it, as that's Dominic Civils with his 2nd sack of the day.
1 touchdown and 3 turnovers. It has not been a great day for the Washington State Cougars offense, but they are 3-for-4 on 3rd down. Let's see if they can make that 4-for-5.
Handoff for Williams. And James Williams, the veteran, is stopped for a loss of 3 by Andrew Thurman, setting up a 4th and 5. I'm surprised Williams isn't used more in this.
4th down and 5, and Washington State will go for it. I think this is the right call from the Cougars. It's Connor Neville all alone in the backfield. 5 wide set. Neville, under a little bit of pressure, he's going to find Caleb Perry, the running back, for a 1st down conversion.
It is 1st and goal at the 8, as Washington State is 0-for-1 in the red zone after fumbling it the first time. Let's see if they can get some points and make this game a little bit closer. Handoff for Chris Lee. Lee shrugs off multiple tackles. Excellent run. And Lee will get the score.
It is 2nd down and 10 for the Hornets. Minute 15 to go here in the third quarter. They lead it by 10. As it's going to be an option. Britton tosses it for Michael Wilson. For receiver. And Wilson, there he goes down the field. I don't think anyone will catch him. And Wilson will eventually be pushed out of bounds, but not before a big gain, as Wilson gets more yards than Alex Ellis has all day. And Wilson, who has been excellent for this offense, making a play on the ground.
It is 1st down after the big play from the slot wide receiver, Michael Wilson. Westlake is in the red zone. They are perfect in the red zone. And why not keep it perfect, as Britton to the freshman, Everett Lemieux, for the touchdown, and Westlake extends their lead.
3rd down and 10. Just under 30 seconds left to go in quarter number 3, as Connor Neville, he will be sacked by the defensive tackle QJ Kazmir, who has been phenomenal the past couple weeks for Westlake, with another sack that'll force a Cougar punt.
Westlake got some really good starting field position on this drive after a good punt return by the redshirt sophomore running back Alex Ellis, as Britton keeps it on the option, but he is flattened to the ground by Faave. 4th down and 7. Westlake isn't in field goal range, but they're also not in punting range. So they're going to go for it, as Britton, He's going to look short for an open man. That's Alex Ellis for running back, who will gain 13 and a first down. Just under 3.5 minutes left to go. Hornets ended up kicking a field goal anyway, so it's 34-14. As Neville, under pressure, he's going to be sacked. That's QJ Kazmir with his second sack of the afternoon, or I guess night, because it's not really afternoon anymore. Just under 3 minutes left to go here, as Wazoo trying to make a miracle comeback. Can they do it? I kind of doubt it. As Neville, under pressure, this time it's Isaac Solomon, the redshirt freshman with the sack. Solomon has been playing pretty well the past couple weeks as he makes another play right there. 4th and 8, and Wazoo is unsurprisingly going to go for it as Neville is incomplete. He was almost sacked by Rivero, so he had to throw it. Hobie got lucky, which he didn't get lucky. And that is how this game ends. The Hornets win their 3rd straight, improving to 6-3 as they clinch a bowl game for the 4th straight season. They are now 5-1, I believe, in conference. Washington State is now 3-6, 1-5. In conference. Westlake's next game will be Senior Day against the Arizona State Sun Devils, so stay tuned.